Hello. Welcome back once again to another edition of Behind the Lens with yours truly. It's game day, week six, game six. The county has lifted the mandate, so, or the city or whatever, so I will wear my mask tonight, Mr. Spurlock. But for right now, just for a short minute, I'm going to talk to these kids. How are you? How you doing? Week six, game six is finally here. How you doing? Well, hopefully good. Let's not lose focus of what we're supposed to be doing. And I don't mean to be violating any type of rule on this grounds or anything, but let's always wear our mask, do the right thing, and be cautious of others. We're halfway through this thing, guys. And if you're going to the championship, yeah, you got 10 more. That starts tonight at week six. Some of you, you need to get your stuff together now if you're going to try to make a run at the playoffs. Got a lot of great games tonight. We'll be here at the Inferno. Let's run down them. Florence is at BA, so Will Hester will come up and play Brentwood Academy. Brentwood Academy, 5-0, a good team. Station Camp at Stewart's Creek. A Station Camp, you need a lot of help. I've looked at your scores, don't know much about what your attack is tonight. Ben Cottle, get those twos and threes in. Yellow. Yeah. Well, I've had the phone off the hook. Didn't want to talk to you. Nope. Where are you at tonight? IMG Ravenwood, the number one team in the nation. ESPNU. Well, Krager, what have you been doing? Getting ready. But the game? Well, you're not going to be on ESPNU. Well, I mean, they may flash you on the sidelines or whatever, but it's not like they're going to say, and now we'll go to Tom Krager with the Tennessean and get his thoughts on that first half. I don't think that's happening, Coach. Yeah. We got Cecil. I hear the voice of Cecil Joyce. Where we got him? Okay, he's here at the Inferno. There's a lot of good games. I like that Brentwood CPA. I circled some that I still like. I think there's a better game. I mean, IMG's going to blow them up. Ravenwood can't. I don't know. They're not going to have any game. I don't know. Because it is ESPN. My goodness. Yeah. All right. Well, I don't have much else to discuss with you. You know, all right, I've got things to do. Topics to discuss, people to talk to. Students are waiting on me. My fans, Tom. My fans. Oh, you got to be kidding me. Huh? So you'd like for the fans to have like 100 to 200 masks like I've got? Well, at $14.95, that's a nice ROI. Well, I'm sure you would get on ESPNU if we did that. But I'm not spending $14.95 times 100. Shoot, Tom, that's 16 sales tax and everything. And who would want 100 face masks? I guess they would be. Would you sign them afterwards? After everybody been all, I don't hope not. Let's talk later. Man, you're a mess. Bye. Tom Krager with the Tennessean. We mostly take care of Cecil Joyce, the voice of Cecil Joyce. Let's get back to it. A Tyner visits Alcoa, and then Rockville, you're going over to Oakland, and Rick Rice will get a first taste of Ray Hughes Stadium. Coffee County and Cookeville will get back on the winning track. Nothing against Coffee County. I just don't think you got enough gunpowder for Stockton Owen and his thing. Here's an interesting one. Phillip and William Blount got blowed out by McMinn, and he said five turnovers cost them that game, and looking to get back on the right track, he takes on, I gotta love this name, kids, Sevier County and the Smoky Bears. Christian Brothers off, Rodney Salisbury, gosh, the Memphis and that whole deal, bad deal. I hate it for you guys. Hopefully we get something back on track, and then right here at the Inferno, Riverdale versus Blackman. Let's get into it. Let's get some topics. Here's an old rapper from a previous lens. Let's get a drink of coffee, settle down here. I'll tell you what, maybe if I put this on, I could put this back on, and then I'd be like John Gruden and Sean Smith. It was $100,000 if you did not wear your mask, I think it was, $100,000. So we'll put it on and do a topic so I don't get fined. What if we find Tom Crager? Kentucky self-defense law made homicide charges unlikely. Oakland's mansion hosts Oktoberfest. Scout builds the deliveries and sheriff's canine units. Bigger than the final score. Oakland's Ty Nix shakes hands with his father, Tyrone. Ty Nix, kids, he's been on Stork Vision. He's a color dude on Stork Vision. Great guy, played at Oakland. Gotta love Ty Nix. Mid-season report. Did we not just have that Wednesday night viral moment, best moment, big surprise? Let's find a topic. I hear the voice of Cecil Joyce. You ever try something that just blows up in your face? You ever watch my broadcast? You know, this whole thing's been about trying something and letting it blow up in my face. Everything we do since the start, when I started this thing and I got a camera, got up on top of a press box, it's been about trying something, watch it blow up in my face. Just watch it blow up. I mean, we've tried everything. I used to run sidelines. I bought a camera called 360. Blew up in my face. I got the data back, couldn't put it in. It was gibberish. You couldn't do anything with it. The fam wouldn't have appreciated it. But we invested money in that and it didn't work. Used to have a sound box that we ran from one camera to the other, and that sound box was not, it was not, it just wasn't consistent. It didn't work. We tried it. Blew up in my face. Everything's been a blow up in my face. I can't tell you how many times it's happened. But isn't that what school's all about? Isn't that what you're going to school? Is to try something, and if it blows up in your face, the other night over here at Rockdale, Rick Rice's offensive, and I'm not picking on you, coach, Rick Rice's offensive coordinator tried three times to run a screen pass to Cole Getty. I'm not being mean or anything. If you watch their film, they run the play. It's coming. But what I'm saying is they tried it three times and it blew up in their face. And then finally they got it, but it was toward the end of the game. But he wanted to get that in because he believed in it. But what happens when something blows up in your face? Let's break that down and go backwards. It's because we didn't work on it enough, usually. We didn't think it through. But we tried. Maybe we went out there and we thought we had it and we didn't have it. Maybe only had six that knew the play. And I'm not picking on anybody. Goodness me. This whole thing, and we get it, is I am you. This behind the lens, I am you. I am you, the student. I've tried things. There's a lot of grown-ups, kids. They won't stick their foot in the water. I will. I'm with you. I'm learning right with you. This whole company, this whole thing has been about trying something, which is what you're supposed to do when you're a young kid, and then working on it. So, but it blows up in your face so many times, doesn't it? Huh? You know, but you keep doing it. And then eventually you get it. And then you say, you know, hey, he got it. It doesn't blow up in his face no more. Let's get a new topic. And we'll tie it in. I almost let it out of the bag. And didn't take a breath. Let's take the mask off. I think that's affecting me a little bit. Give me a minute, Coach Burlock. Getting better. You know, we try something and then it blows up. Well, what do you got to do? You just got to get better at it. How do you get better at it? Well, we keep practicing. We keep working on it. We keep trying. Maybe the chemistry isn't there. Maybe that's it. Or maybe it was just not, we didn't work on it. I think so many times, and I'm going to talk about myself, I don't think I ever reached the pinnacle of where you were supposed to go in basketball. I did not break on through to the other side. Does that make sense? In getting better. I got better through the process, but I never broke on through to the other side and then got on out there in that new space. Does that make sense? I played high school basketball, and I played all 4 years. I wasn't a big star. Now, I played a lot in practice, but me and the coach, we didn't quite get along that well. Our philosophies were a little different at that time, and I was normally into trying things, and it normally blew up in my face, I'll be the first to say. But at the end of the day, you know, he didn't get me. But what I love about all this is, you know, this whole thing is what I was talking about is most of the people like Steve Luker, Mr. Lawless, Ben Cottle gets it, Creasy gets it, Kreisky gets it, assistant principal over at my new friend over at River, a lot of people, David Limbaugh gets it, so many people get it, and that is, you know, this whole thing is about giving back, but plus it's about, you know, participating, you know, and getting better. I started in youth football in 1998. I spent from 8 o'clock in the morning till 10 o'clock at night. I called 8 football games a day, and I gave back from 98 till 2002. I did not stop. I did that. And during that time, I picked up high school football. I got better at it. Isn't that what you're supposed to do? Isn't that what schooling's all about? You start at first grade, go all the way up to 12, and you get better. This whole thing has been about getting better. We started off with the camera. We got out here to the press box, just like I said a while ago. You tried certain things, they didn't work, you got better at it. We started off in 720 by 480. That was direct TV or digital video at that time. It was a little better than what you call 320 by 240, which is normal VHS tapes. Those are those big square things that go into the machine. I still got a bunch of those. And now we're all into hard drives, and went through the DVD era. I used to sit right up there, and Mr. Lawless used to wait on me because we were going through our technology and whatnot, burning DVDs to get to Coach Shad Owens. We were learning. We were growing. We were getting better. We were about producing a different trade because we used to trade. We traded with Smyrna. I went down here to the end of the road one time. We traded at a gas station. Used to trade DVDs. That was fun. Traded VHSs. Now you do it all online. We got better. And some of the things you've tried out here to implement, you tried them. They didn't work. They blew up in your face. But you got better. And that's what we're going to continue to do. The season, this whole show, this whole thing has been about me growing with you and you watching me. I make mistakes, kids. I make a lot of them. But daggone it, I'm going to try to do my best, get the track back on and go again, because that's what I want you to do. You got to. I have failed many a times. But finally, look at it now. I'm with the right company, the right group of people, the right attitude, the right mission statement. I mean, these guys, I ain't even gone to work for them yet, and they're getting business like crazy. Why? Because they know I'm coming, and they know anything I get my hands on, I'm going to deliver. Man, I'm going to knock it out of the park. I'm going to smash it like you've never seen it. And I'm excited about that. I got a long way to go. I got to get better with this team, okay? I already know what to do in the biz, but I got to do it with this group of people. So there'll be a learning process, and there'll be a few things that'll blow up in my face, but I'll get better at it. So tonight, and this week, and next month, and the rest of your life, always remember one thing. Things are going to blow up in your face. But I want you to try things, not things that don't do anything, break the law. And don't do anything, get Bill Spurlock mad. But anyway, You know, I want you to continue to try things and do things and push the envelope, but not in the sense of getting in trouble. I don't need a principal after me. I don't need Steve Luker after me. I want you to push things, and then I want you to get better. But just don't be frustrated and say that didn't work or whatever. Break it back down. I'm still learning, try to play the guitar. I'm about to break on through to the other side. What do you think that's gonna do for this show when I'm out here playing the guitar? Tom Krieger don't play the guitar, and neither does the voice of Cecil Joyce. Now the voice of Cecil Joyce used to have a karaoke machine, but he don't have the karaoke machine no more. I don't know what happened. Dance fever ended. Kids, let's get out of here. I've enjoyed it so much. I love coming out here. I love talking to you. I love our relationship. I want to thank all those schools out there that let me come do this. It means more to me than it's just me and Judy. We have a big time. I went to school, studied broadcasting, public relations, advertising, newspaper, stuff like that. I've got a warehouse full of old newspapers just like this. I keep every one of them. I've had a good time, and I look forward to doing the rest of the season. I don't know what will happen with this model, but I've got a good feeling. But I think we're going to be okay. I was a little nervous there for a little bit, but I think we're going to be okay. I think you, the fam, will keep me in gear. But until then, take care. God bless. Take care. I'm a man who truly, truly delivers. That's me, the stork. It's been a long lens, and I just felt like I didn't do a good job the last time, and I knew I could do better. I've been on the road. I went to that funeral in Fairhope, and that's another thing, kids. We're going to take this show on the road. Tom Krieger won't be going, but I'm going to Bay Minette, and I'm going to Foley, and I'm going to L.A. That's the dream. That's the something. And it may blow up in my face. Blow up in my face. No, I think I'll just go down there and blow it up. That's what I think I'll do. Go down there and blow it up. Blow it up. See you tonight, kids.